Hello students, welcome back. We are going to concentrate today in the continuation in specifications, lecture number 7. In this video, only one specification we are going to focus on, plastering in cement mortar. So, as we know that plastering work is carried out for wall surfaces, ceiling, external wall surface, and in water tanks, etc. So for that particular work, for plastering work, there are some specifications mentioned. So for surface of wall should be raked up to 18 mm deep. The courses of bricks in masonry have joints, horizontal joints and vertical joints. So those joints should be raked up to 18 mm deep. The surface of the wall should be washed and kept clean. And also it should be wet for 2 days before plastering work to be carried out. Then specifications of materials used in plastering work. Materials like cement and sand should be of standard specifications. Mixing specification. First, we have to mix the materials in dry condition. And then add water slowly and mix it properly and then use it for plastering. The plastering thickness should be 12 mm thick. So 12 mm thickness of one coat, such 2 to 3 coats of thickness, 2 to 3 coats of plastering is given. Ceiling plastering is done first and then wall. Here there should be a little bit change in the sentence. So, colon should be given there. Ceiling plastering first and then wall plastering need to be done. External plastering should be carried out from top to bottom. So, top to bottom means, say consider if you are having ground floor plus first floor external wall, you have to start from the top of parapet and then come down till the ground level. Next, in internal plastering should be carried out after removal of the centering. Centering in the sense the formwork or the props which are given for the slabs at the bottom. So after removal of the centering work, we have to start with the plastering. Before internal plastering, ceiling plastering should be carried out for the bottom surface of the slab. So first coat 10 mm thick. So the first coat is also called as a rendering coat. So first coat, whether it is internal or external coat, so it should be of 10 mm thickness. Second coat should be between 10 to 6 mm thick, and also that second coat is called as floating coat. Third coat should be of 5 to 6 mm, and this third coat is said to be finishing coat. So total minimum thickness should be of 20 mm thickness. Say consider first coat is of 10 mm, second coat may be of 6 mm and third coat may be of 5 mm. So total it will be 21 mm thickness. So you may reduce somewhere here and there in second and third coat. So first coat may be 10 mm, second coat may be of 7 mm and third coat may be of again 5 mm, so it may be 22 mm thick. So minimum thickness should be of 20 mm. So minimum, you can exceed more than 20 mm also by the examples likewise I given just now. So testing, what test to be done while the progress of the work or progress of plastering work is going on. So verticality using plumb bob need to be checked, because the even thickness should be maintained at all the corners or all full surface of the wall. In one corner it is of say 20 mm, in another corner it is of 25 mm, or another corner it may be of 22 mm or 23 mm. It should not be like that. So to get that thickness, even thickness for full surface of wall, the verticality should be checked by using plumb bob. Curing, so after finishing of plastering work of full wall surface, you have to keep the surface wet for minimum of 10 days. So the plastering work is carried out with the measurement square meters. Unit of measurement for plastering is square meters. So length of the wall and height of the wall is going to give us the measurement of the plastering work. So it is said to be measurement or the specifications. So in examination you may write the same points and elaborate these points, and it will give you the full answer for the specifications, specification for plastering in cement mortar. So thank you students, we will again come back in lecture number 8.